Congratulations, you've made it to the final video in Google Sheets, and you may be wondering what to do next. Well, I'm here to discuss a couple of possible next steps for you in learning to work with data and in learning to work with Google Sheets. The most important thing is to do it yourself. Get started and get mixed in with things. You want to get some data and you just want to try, see how things work in Google Sheets. You can do a little bit of experimenting, a little feeling around, see how it behaves and what you can get out of it to serve your own purposes. Now, what you're going to need to do is get some data. Now, chances are you already have some data where you work. You may have, if you're in an organization that does email marketing, you'll have the names and the email addresses and the location information, maybe information about open rates and click-throughs on your email newsletters. That's a great place to get data. You can download that from your email service provider. You may have social media data, things like who's following you, who's commenting, where they are, when they last interacted, what they said, and how they connected and how they shared things and what they really believed about all of it. This is information that is also available to you through the analytics of your social media host. Like if you're using Buffer or Hootsuite, you can get this information and start putting it into Google Sheets and see what you can do. Also, you may have sales data or some other kind of interaction. You might know what kind of items people are buying or what services they're requesting, whether a first time or a repeat customer, and also the path to purchase. Did they click on a thing in Instagram and get to Facebook and get to your web page? And that is a lot of information that can be very helpful for businesses and for service organizations to start better understanding how people are interacting with them and how they can reach out. If you have that data available to you, download it, see what you can do with it in Google Sheets beyond what you can do with the built-in analytics of each of these programs. Also, you can get free data. For instance, data.gov is one of the best sources of open data in the United States. You can search for a lot of other different sources. Here I'm showing I went to data.gov and I typed in the word art. I'm looking for data sets on art. I have over 11,000 data sets found. And you know, you just click on this little CSV, which stands for comma separated values. That'll download a spreadsheet that you can open up in Google Sheets and you can get started with open data. You can also get data from Google Trends. And that's a service from Google that lets you see over time the relative popularity of different search terms. Here I've got two German operas, Die Fledermaus and Der Rosenkavalier. And you can see that, for instance, the second one was more popular back in May of 2017, but the first one's been more popular since then. You can download that data by clicking on this button right here and start seeing what you can do with it in your own analysis. Finally, there's Google Correlate, one of my favorite services that lets you look at the popular search terms over time, like we had with Google Trends, but it also lets you look at state-by-state comparisons, where it gives you a number in terms of the, actually it's standard deviations of each state in terms of the relative popularity of a search term within that state. One of my favorite ones here is the search for modern dance. And you can get that information, you can download it right here by clicking on CSV. And just in case you're wondering, the state that is head and shoulders above every other in the entire United States in terms of searches for modern dance is right here in Utah where I live. It's one of the more shocking things in terms of data-driven insights. Now, there's other things that you can learn, and I suggest that if you start here with Google Sheets, you might want to try to learn some more things. So, for instance, here at DataLab CC, available either right now or in the near future, are courses on data principles. I've been showing you the tools and I've been showing you how to work the tools, but the concepts, what does it mean to do a regression? What does it mean to have a standard deviation? I'm going to talk about those things in these other courses. I also have sets of courses on the other applications within the Google Drive Office Suite. So that's things like Google Docs for preparing reports and Google Slides for making presentations, Google Forms for gathering new data through online surveys. And of course, there's the Microsoft Office complement of all of those, Excel and PowerPoint and Word. In addition to those, if you decide that you need more than a spreadsheet can do easily for you, you might want to try statistical software. I suggest Jamovi, a new and not very well known, but immensely wonderful application that you can download, upload your CSV, and start doing high quality statistical analyses. It's free, it's open source, it's based on R, but it operates with drop-down menus that make analysis very easy. Also, SPSS is a common choice in a lot of different fields, in nursing, in education, in the social sciences. We have courses on SPSS, and if that's the one that's most common in your field, try to get your data into that and see what kind of statistical modeling you can do there as well. And then, of course, if you want to go beyond that, you could try statistical programming in languages like R and Python. We have our first course in R currently available. Python will soon follow. And in any of these, you're going to be able to build on what you've done in Google Sheets, the insight that you've gotten, and you'll be able to build on it to get more statistical modeling, more predictive analytics, more ways of finding what you need. And so it's time to get moving. Get some data, get going. I'm so grateful that you joined us here at datalab.cc. I hope this has been an eye-opening experience and an opportunity for you to get working with your data, to find ways that you can run your organization, your business, and your own personal projects more effectively and more efficiently. Thanks for joining me, and good luck.